ArtCenter of Florida is a contemporary visual art center, and we have here almost 40 artists in residence where they work in their studios, and we have a whole programming of exhibition series and public programs and outreach programs and educational programs. And we are partnering with many other organizations here in Miami. We think that collaboration and partnerships are a must between cultural organizations, and we are really, really happy and proud to have the New World Symphony here at the Art Center, such an amazing organization with a very, very talented and bright musicians, and it's a pleasure having them here playing once a month. It's an opportunity of listening to classical music in a very different environment, and I think that it enhances a cultural experience. The audience have the chance to listen to chamber music in an environment with contemporary visual art, and they have also the chance to get in and out and wandering around their center, meet the artists, talk to them, talk to the musicians. I think that is a very, very fresh project program.
World Symphony really encourages musicians to explore different ways of engaging the audience and the communities they live in. So we have a number of different concert formats that allow the musicians to explore their own ideas inside the concert hall, and it also provides them inspiration to bring those ideas out in the community, just like you see here tonight.
The name Impromptu sort of stuck out as representing this spontaneous nature, almost maybe more for the audience than for us, because the concerts are planned in advance, but the audience doesn't know they're going to see a concert until they walk by most of the time. So that's the impromptu part of the series.
We have the people who are just walking by, and they look in through the window and they're like, what's going on? And they come in, and even if they only stay for 15 minutes, it makes me happy because it's like an unplanned gift that we gave to them. And they didn't know that day that they were going to go out and see a string quartet playing.
Arrive here to the Art Center, and they have the chance to listen to this amazing music and see visual art. It's important to find any way to expose the public and the audience to a cultural experience, whether it's music, whether it's theater, it's visual arts. I think that finding new ways and different ways to expose the public to these experiences is really important.
The kids can come right up and sit right in front of us. We've had kids come and sit down, you know, like a foot away from our instruments, and they're just so fascinated getting to see the music making up close rather than having some kind of barrier like a stage and an audience. It's really touching to see how emotionally they respond. They start dancing and singing, and these are all things that would be inappropriate in a concert setting, but if it's their natural response, then this is a great way to let that out, and instead of stifling it, I think it should be encouraged.
Not having a clear program, we kind of walk in here with a bag of music and we look around and see who showed up and what we can do.
Dealing with kind of the crash and burn situations where if we're playing a difficult piece that none of us has ever played together before and maybe it falls apart and you got the audience right here in front of you, and it's like, how do you recover? And we're just shouting out measure numbers and people are all over the place. But I think as embarrassing as that can be sometimes, it definitely puts everything on a more human level for the audience too, and it doesn't need to be perfect in this setting. That's not the goal, and it's probably more fun to see that it's a process. Music making is a process. It's not just doesn't just happen.
I think this venue is so great because the windows just catch so much attention from the people passing by, and a really relaxed environment. People get inspired to come in, and it's always kind of surprising to me to see the types of people that sit through an entire chamber music work, because often in a concert you get fidgety, you get tired, but in this environment where it's very relaxed, the musicians are wearing street clothes, if you will. They can just sit and take it in, and it's really surprising the types of people that seem to enjoy it.
When you actually get people to come in off the street, it means that you're grabbing them in a very powerful way, and you get that instant feedback of whether what you're doing is creating a response. And the longer people stay, you can tell how interested they are and that you're really connecting.
Thank you.